Shalom and welcome back to my vlog. I hope you are enjoying my Cyprus travels. This is vlog 4 and the final vlog of my Cyprus adventure. I hope you enjoy. Good morning vlog. It is day 4 and it is my last day in Cyprus. So I'm saying goodbye to my nice little home. I'm gonna get on the bus, head to the city, and have a great last day. So I'm just standing here at the bus stop, but look at this view behind me. It is so beautiful. Look at the mountains. There must be something in the water. And there must be something. On the bus, we went by this lake with a bunch of flamingos, and also in the back you can see Sultan Tiki, which is a famous mosque in Larnaca. I got off at the harbor and just looked at all the boats. And then I went to another archaeological site. All right, so I got my ticket and I made it into the archaeology. Why do I keep saying it wrong? Archaeology site. And I'm going to explore. It's called Ancient Kition. Kishon? I'm not really sure. Let's see. Okay, so I just read this information. Here's a map of this. Apparently, okay, what I got out of it is they used to worship Aphrodite in this place in the 13th century. And they took out all of the actual things that they found in here and brought it to the museum. So now it's all just rocks. But let me show you. This is the remains of an ancient city. You can see the walls and the divisions between the rooms. There must be something in the water.
And there must be something that you. Okay, so this says that there was actually a Phoenician colony staying here, and there was a temple built. And the temple actually resembled the pillars of the Temple of Solomon in Jerusalem. So that's quite interesting. So I'm not sure if I was correct about the archaeological sites I went to 2 days ago, but I was thinking that the three different places were actually people's houses. This is smaller, and it actually says it was a whole colony, a whole town. So they must have had really small houses and rooms in here, because let me tell you, it's not that big, and it doesn't compare to each of the houses that I saw at the other place. Definitely seen my fair share of rocks this vacation. Can't believe I keep actually paying to get into these museums to just see rocks. But at least I have the entire place to myself. Literally, Cyprus is empty this time of year. I think that I have seen very few people. The roads are not busy, the museums are not busy, and the beaches are not busy. So it's actually nice.
I then went to the Church of Lazarus, which is this huge, beautiful church. It was beautiful inside. Everything is gold. This would be considered a Greek Orthodox church, which Greek Orthodox is a section that was broken off of the Catholic Church. You can actually go down to Lazarus's tomb and see where he is buried. I know praying like this is common within Catholic sectors of Christianity, but I just thought it was interesting because this woman is praying in front of a picture of Lazarus. I then walked around downtown Larnaca and went to the Larnaca Castle, which is super beautiful. You can go through the inside and also climb up on the top of the castle. Bow.
currently on top of a castle right by the sea. Flashback to Paphos. Now I'm doing it in Larnaca. Hello. Just call me princess.
I then took another photo shoot on top of a castle. They had a mini museum in the castle with a bunch of artifacts. They had the guns and different pottery and things. After all my exploring, I actually walked to the airport, which is surprisingly very close to the city. I got to walk along the promenade by the Mediterranean Sea, and then along this beautiful lake, which the airport is surrounded by. And then I flew home back to Jerusalem. Bye-bye, Cyprus. Thank you for the good times. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!